Have you heard about the largest church in the world? The first service was March 3, 2008, with an attendance of over 300,000. The attendance is now over 2 million, and they conducted the first ever mass trance on March 17, 2008. What do they teach? Who you are requires no belief. Heaven is not a location, but refers to the inner realm of consciousness. The man on the cross is an archetypal image. He is every man and every woman. The leader's website teaches these lessons. My mind is part of God's. I am very holy. My holiness is my salvation. My salvation comes from me. Let me remember that there is no sin. Do not make the pathetic error of, quote, clinging to the old rugged cross, unquote. The only message of the crucifixion is that you can overcome the cross. Have you heard of this church? Or maybe its leader? Years ago, she denied Jesus is the only way.
One of the mistakes that human beings make is believing that there is only one way to live.
That's
and
right.
That we don't accept that there are diverse ways of being in the world, that there are millions of ways to be
then
a human
how do
being.
You please
and,
God?
And many ways, no, but many paths
right.
to what you call God.
That
and
is
her
crazy.
Path might be something else, and when she gets there, she might call it the light. But her loving and her kindness and her generosity brings her, if it brings her to the same point that it brings you, it doesn't matter whether she called it God along the way or not.
And I guess the danger that could be in that, I mean, it sounds great on the onset, but if you really look at both sides,
there couldn't possibly be just one way. What about Jesus? What about Jesus?
You say there isn't only one way. There is one way and only one way, and
there
that is through Jesus.
There couldn't possibly be with
because
the millions
you
of people
say
in
there isn't.
Today she has turned her millions of adoring fans over to New Age doctrine. Christians are letting this into their homes and are being deceived.
Hello again, everyone. Welcome to week number 3 of our New Earth web class. And again, I thank you. Eckhart Tolle thanks you for joining us as we bring students and seekers together to discuss our latest book club selection, Eckhart Tolle's A New
We
Earth.
Did something last week that was unprecedented. You said it's never been done before on television, where you just sit there in silence. I thought a lot of people responded to the sense of connection from that. So you want to do that again?
Yes.
Let's do that again.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So you're going to lead us in silence.
And okay. Simply become aware that you are breathing. The air flows in and out, and you feel yourself breathing. Air flows in and out of the body.
In reading books such as Tolle's, it's really opened my eyes up to a new way of thinking, a new form of spirituality that doesn't always align with the teachings of Christianity. So my question is to you, Oprah, how have you reconciled these spiritual teachings with your Christian belief?
I've reconciled it because I was able to open my mind about the absolute indescribable hugeness of that which we call God. I took God out of the box because I grew up in the Baptist church and there were, you know, rules and, you know, belief systems and doctrine. And I happened to be sitting in church in my late 20s, and I was going to this church where you had to get there at, you know, 8 o'clock in the morning, or you couldn't get a seat, and a very charismatic minister, and everybody was just, you know, into the sermon. And this great minister was preaching about how great God was, and how omniscient and omnipresent, and God is everything. And then he said, and the Lord thy God is a jealous God. And I was, you know, caught up in the rapture of that moment until he said jealous. And something struck me. And I was like, I think about 27 or 28. I was thinking, God is all. God is omnipresent. God is all. And God's also jealous. God is jealous of me. And something about that didn't feel right in my spirit, because I believe that God is love and that God is in all things. And so that's when the search for something more than doctrine started to stir within me. And I love this quote that Eckhart has. This is one of my favorite quotes in chapter 1, where he says, "Man made God in his own image, the eternal, the infinite and unnameable was reduced to a mental idol that you had to believe in and worship as my God or our God.
Jesus says you are the light of the world. That means you are the consciousness in which the world appears, is seen.
So you believe what happens to us at death when the body dies? You don't have a belief.
I don't give it any thought.
You don't. God, in the essence of all consciousness, isn't something to believe. God is.
Yes.
God is. And God is a feeling experience, not a believing experience.
That's right.
And if that your religion is a believing experience, if God for you is still about a belief, then it's not truly God.
No.
That's what you're saying.
Yes.
But that's not all. She's entered the political arena by endorsing a candidate for president. The New Age teacher giving lessons on her website, Marianne Williamson, has started an organization called the Peace Alliance to establish a U.S. Department of Peace. What can we do? Spread the word and tell others to open their eyes. Author Carrington Steele uncovers the truth in a new book, Don't Drink the Kool-Aid. Available at cssteeleonline.com. Christians, time to open your eyes, turn off the TV, and pray.